G'day, my name is Mark, and I have pulled apart many, many, many pine pallets. This video is not about beginner, intermediate, and professional. I am not a professional. These are pine pallets. These are the most accessible pallets out there. They are literally everywhere. A lot of people write them off because they're pine. I want to show you that this stuff will scrub up no matter what tools or equipment or level of experience you have. These are a great way to get started, and they are a great way to make cash. For the first leg style, we're going to use this straightening jig. It's made out of pallets. This works in conjunction with your hand circular saw. Here's a quick tip. Just check your blade is square to the base plate, otherwise you're not going to have a square edge. So I'll do that one again. From here, it's a case of make this as clean as you possibly can with the tools you have. So if that means hand sanding it back. For this particular leg we're doing, number one, that is more than enough. There's gonna be a glue bond there. We're gonna hold it together. It's not gonna come apart. Sand him off, or get yourself a belt sander. Early on, 40 grit. This thing is gonna be your best friend. Now, we're not gonna get all of those rough sawn marks out without heaps and heaps and heaps of sanding. But again, there is plenty of gluing surface, especially if you're using a really good glue, but even the dodgy glues, that is gonna do the job for gluing pallets together. What it also does is this will create a very nice rustic beachy effect later on, which I'll show you with this leg in particular. How easy is that? And as Benny likes to say,
the best fun you can have with your clothes on.
I'm just gonna do the rest with this. There's no noise, there's no dust. And it really does make you feel good on the inside. $2 silicon spatula. That makes life easy. If you don't have many clamps, just screw all these palings together. Let the glue do its job, pull the screws out, happy days. There's already holes all through this stuff anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Next leg, I'm gonna use the table saw to clean up all four sides. I'm gonna use a couple of straightening jigs. I'm gonna use the table saw itself to clean off the faces. I highly recommend getting a table saw early on if you're gonna get into this whole pallet wood game. It's definitely a game changer for straightening, cleaning up. It then becomes so versatile for so many things. It'll be the workhorse of the pallet punter arena. This is one of my straightening jigs. You probably don't need this many toggle clamps. These things do hold down a lot of pressure. In fact, one clamp can almost do the job when the pallet paling is pushed up against the side. With that downward pressure, it's really got nowhere to go. I went with four pieces for this one because I want to get a nice square profile, but all of those have just been run through the table saw on their four sides. That doesn't mean they're going to be perfectly square, but we're going to get pretty close when we glue it up. It's already pretty close. Nice chunky pine beams. They're a winner. These pipe clamps, cheapies, Amazon, eBay, 40 bucks for four. Buy the pipe clamp, you're about 100 bucks, good to go. Get you in the game of clamping more bigger things together. Okay, so for the last leg, I'm going to use my bigger machines. This one was actually gifted to me. Very fortunate to have this beautiful machine. I'd probably have a jointer by now anyway from all the furniture I've made. So we're going to use this, the table saw, and the thicknesser behind me to make all of these super square, super flat, and clean, ready for their glue up. So leg number three, we have four pieces of timber, all cleaned up, square on all four sides. So we should be able to glue those together and have a perfectly square, chunky beam. However, we can then take this chunk of wood back onto the jointer, back through the thicknesser, and get a perfectly milled, beautifully square chunk of wood. First joint I want to cut on my number one leg, which is my rough and ready, throw it together style. We're gonna do a half lap. We're gonna use a circular saw and our square to cut multiple cuts in the end, knock it out with a hammer, clean it up with a chisel, half lap, good to go. Now to get a nice clean cut on the bottom, we're gonna throw some sacrificial stock on one of the sides to give the saw a little bit more to hang on to stop it tilting back and forth and potentially putting little cuts grubbing up that joint. Okay, here we go, joint number one, circular saw cleaned up with the chisel. This is great for building shop furniture, but stick with me because we want to make some money. If you love those couple of little tips about a circular saw, for the price of a chicken parmajama at the pub, you can jump onto Uncle Knacker's masterclass for the circular saw. Chicken parmajama, how cheap is that? Anyway, this course is jam-packed with amazing tips. I've been following, watching Uncle Knacker's videos for years. His videos are full of amazing tips. This is all about the circular saw. You'll pick something up. It's really good. Go and check it out.
Great tip, Knackers!
This blade is a ripping blade. However, it's got a flat tooth grind on top. This is makes it easy to do nice clean joints. A crosscut blade would be better for less chip out and the like, but I find this the most versatile. And as long as it's sharp, it does an amazing job. That's a pretty quick and easy way of doing it. It gets a reasonable cut off the saw. I will clean it up with a chisel to get a better glue bond. And that is a pretty decent joint for this pine stuff. What I love about the pine as well is it really let me practice, learn things about making stuff fit nicely. Again, if you stuff it up, you just go and get another pallet. The third leg, it is the chunkiest of all three because I wasn't limited by the table saw or anything else. I'm not going to bother showing you how to do another half lap. Probably the most efficient way to cut a half lap is do your cross cut. If you've got a bandsaw, you can then make your other cut and remove all that waste in one go. If you're just running a table saw, you can make yourself a tenoning jig, which lets you cut out all the waste in one go as well. Super fast. Freak anyone out. Okay, here we go. Three pine chunks of wood can be used for frames, legs, whatever you want in whatever pallet furniture you're making. This one, the first one that was cleaned up with the day one jig, so I've got a pretty clean side. Then I've got the untouched side just to really emphasize the texture when we put the finish onto this one. Number two, cleaned up with the table saw, and these two have had a quick sand. We're gonna stick some paint on that one. And number three, nice and chunky, super square, clean, and we're also gonna paint this one. Pine generally doesn't get a lot of love, as you may or may not know. My main drama with pine is it yellows, really does look like 80s furniture. What we're gonna do is put some finishes on these because in my opinion, putting something on top of the pine just makes it another lump of wood that looks pretty cool. We're going to put a stain and varnish on this one that has all that texture. White paint on number two, the table saw only leg. And I have some black paint in an enamel for leg number three. Let me paint them, clean them up, and then quick chat to what I reckon is the best. Also, we all love jigs. One, because they make life easier. Two, because they are generally the free option to making something that an expensive tool does anyway. So why don't you go and check out James's video. It's all about good jigs for the workshop. While you're there, why don't you go and sub up to James? He has a massive catalog of garage woodworker cool stuff. Brush strokes in this style is a good thing, so don't worry about those. Here's number three. I have chamferizationed this one up. This one has the cleanest faces, no rustic charm at all. We're going to paint this one a solid color, and it's going to hide all of those things that people don't really like about pine and what people don't really like about pine pallets.
Alrighty!
Three styles of pine pallets. Number one, very rough, very rustic. This one just has a stain on it. You can see all the color and the texture. Just keep applying stain, sand it back until you come up with a look that you like, that very much ticks the rustic charm box. Just flip it over so you can see how much character you can show from the saw marks from that rough sawn pine. Also, it looks pretty good on tabletops as well. If you come across some old chunky beams, they don't need a lot of work, but they will look pretty cool. Second one is what I call just a whitewashed finish. I did heaps of this, and what I would do is just go and buy a 6 liter bucket of ceiling white, because it's nice and white and it is super cheap. Like, it was $22 for about 6 liters. Slap that on, sand it off, reveal as much of the pine as you wish. Then put some poly over the top, seal off the timber. Number three, the chamferized big chunky leg. Two coats of black enamel paint. There is plenty that you can do with that as well. Also, don't be shy to use a bit of color. Also, pretty popular. So because there is plenty of pine laying around, I would use these mostly for legs and frames for my hallway tables that I talked about heaps in my last video on how I got started. Once you got all this stuff, you then go on with making slabs out of all your good pallets. Anything with good color, slap these on top and you've got yourself a pretty unique, cool hallway table that people like to buy. The big secret on which one of these sells the most. Now, there is, let's just say, one person in most household that likes to spend the money, likes to buy nice things to put in places and fill up every spot in the house. That person loves the whitewashed furniture, especially in my part of the world. It just has that fresh look. This has been the most popular style for my frames, other bits and pieces on the furniture, where the pallet wood would then feature on the top or on the sides. That's why I've done heaps of it. Once all these finishes go on, generally, you can't tell it's pine. And the big thing is the people buying this stuff, they don't care. They don't care what's made of. They just want something that looks cool. So that's why I keep making it. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you to all the new people that have recently subbed, thanks to my last video on how I got started. Okay, catch you later. Next video is all about these slabs, so hope to see you on that one. There's a bit of bacon on my camera lens. Stand by.